how should I breathe right now so that to get more oxygen for my mind, inside my brain, inside my heart, muscles, so that I can function better. But there is even more fundamental question. Because I can do these exercises maybe for 10 minutes, half an hour, 1 hour per day, but for the remaining part of the day, how should I breathe? How should I breathe during sleep, at rest, when I'm reading the book, when I'm writing, working on computer, doing some other activities? What would be the optimum breathing pattern for better oxygenation of brain, heart, kidneys, liver, other organs of the human body? Of course, to find the truth, to find the answer, we need tests. Which tests would be considered? Doctors can measure oxygen content in tissues, in blood, inside the lungs. We can measure frequency of breathing. We can measure how heavy is our breathing. But all these tests, we need special equipment. But there is one very simple test, which is very sensitive to oxygen level in the human body, inside the tissues, exactly what we need. And since my talk is based on this test, I'm going to explain and focus on this test right now. This is what Dr. Buteyko told about this test. Oxygen content in the organism can be found using a simple method. After exhalation, observe how long the person can pause their breath without stress. Dr. Buteyko, public lecture in the Moscow State University on 9 December 1969. Dr. Buteyko was absolutely right. Moreover, there is a lot of Western research telling that breath holding time is indeed very sensitive to oxygen level inside our tissues. And for this reason, I also do this test with my students and when I give lectures or talks like this, because my following lecture, my talk, my presentation is based on this test. This test is called breath holding time test. How do we do the test? When we do the test, we can imagine our breathing pattern before the test is following. We take inhale, and then we exhale. Inhale, exhale. This is how we breathe at rest all the time, even without thinking. After one of the exhales, we pinch the nose, mouth of course is closed, and we hold our breath. But we hold our breath only till the first desire to breathe. It may be 10, 15, 20 seconds, depends on the person, on oxygen level. And when you get the very first desire, it would be maybe swelling movement or push of the diaphragm, then you need to release the nose. If you do it exactly at this moment of time, your breathing pattern would be unchanged. So after the test, your breathing would be the same as before the test. So it's easy, comfortable, stress-free test. Western doctors usually do so-called maximum time test, breath holding time test, and many people get stressed. In fact, if people are suffering from, for example, high blood pressure, panic attacks, migraine headaches, they can get symptoms of these diseases if they overdo the test. So for them it's particularly important to stop in time. As soon as we feel first discomfort, first stress, which would be growing in time after this moment, breath holding time, then we need to immediately release the nose. So this is what we call breath holding time test. I write here breath holding time. And I did this test thousands of times with many, many people. And what I found, people often do the following mistake. We breathe normally before the test. Then we hold the breath. And at this moment of time, we feel first stress, but we are uncertain. And we overdo the test maybe by 2, 3, 5 seconds, a little bit more. But stress is already increasing. And when we overdo the test, by a little bit, the breathing pattern after the test gets disturbed. We take big inhale that already tells us about stress. And this is not correct way of doing the test. Now, since this test again very important for this lecture, for understanding of discoveries made by Russian spaceship doctor, Dr. Buteyko, let us do this test together. So how we do the test? When I say 3, 2, 1, you just relax. And when I say start, you pinch the nose, mouth is closed, and we are going to count how much is oxygen in your body, how much is index of oxygenation and breath holding time. So we can start this test in 3 seconds. 2, 1, exhale and start. And you can relax, hold your breath, 5 seconds. 10. 15, 20. If it's enough, you may finish already. 25. 30. Some people have even more than 30. It's good if you have more than 30, because most people have maybe 15, 20 seconds only. And what would be the normal breath holding time? Let me quote you a sentence from physiology textbook. If a person breath holds after a normal exhalation, it takes about 40 seconds before breathing commences. Essentials of exercise physiology, 2000. Please also remember that the test should be done accurately so that we know oxygen level. It's not the test when we are trying to push ourselves, to stress ourselves. We want to find the oxygen level. And what we also know, that it's possible to change breathing pattern so that people get better breath holding time. And what I did in the past, I wrote a book, Normal Breathing, the Key to Vital Health. It's about the Buteyko breathing method and about many studies done on the West in relation to breathing. How breathing relates to diseases. What about different breathing patterns? So in this book, I have a table. And you can look this table online. It's on my website, normalbreathing.com. You can go on big book. Chapter 1 of book is online. And you have this big table from Western studies, telling us that breath holding time in sick people is invariably low. It's usually less than 20, 10, 15 seconds. People with asthma, heart disease, COPD, diabetes, other conditions, they have breath holding time which is quite short. And when people are healthy, breath holding time should be about 40 seconds, but very few people have these days a lot of oxygen in the body. What Dr. Buteyko did, he developed a method how to retrain breathing. And one of his pupils wrote a PhD thesis about this test, and he proved that this test, in fact, is much more informative, sensitive to the health of people. In sick people, it's invariably short. Breath holding time can be as low as 5-7 seconds when people are severely sick. Whereas in healthy people, it's up to 25, 30, 35. And in the past 100 years ago, as this table shows, there are studies done about 100 years ago on this breath holding time test. Because you just need a simple watch. Breath holding time was up to 46, 49, 47, 45, just in ordinary people. And we can imagine that something happened with our breathing during 100 years, and we're going to discuss this question as well. But right now, the question which we need to ask ourselves would be how breath holding time, this index of oxygenation, relates to the breathing pattern. How should I breathe at rest so that my oxygen content in the brain, in heart, in muscles, other organs is high? Maybe I should have fast breathing, shallow breathing, deep breathing. Maybe I should sigh or take some delays, breath holds in between. So what would be the best breathing pattern at rest in order to provide optimum oxygenation? And this is the subject of the next part of my talk.